Thank you very much. Welcome to Johannesburg, the host city of the opening game of the 2013 Africa Cup of Nations. Now, I must explain this Bafana Bafana shirt I'm wearing to you. I'm quite uneasy, but that's because I support Nigeria. In the spirit of the tournament, though, I've decided to give the host nation some love. This is Park Station. It's a major transport hub for minibuses and for trains. It's also where most of the fans arriving to watch the tournament will come to. From here, they'll be ferried free of charge to Soccer City. That's because the local organizing committee has organized buses for them. Now, if you're one of those fans coming to Johannesburg for the tournament, let me give you a little tour of the city and tell you what you might expect. So I'm now on my way to Soccer City, but first I need to buy some tickets. Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Yes.
Can I have tickets for the opening game?
The couple sold out.
Sold out?
Yes.
What? Okay, my second choice, Nigeria versus Zambia.
Yes, we do have that one.
And how much is that?
50 rand.
50 rand?
Yes.
There you go. That's about $6. And you can buy tickets ranging all the way up to $24 for the most expensive ones. Now, if you don't have tickets for the opening game, do not despair. The organizers, CAF, are a bit worried that they've only been able to sell 50% of the tickets. So there are still tickets available. You can buy them in convenience stores like this or in shopping malls dotted across the country.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you very much and see you. Bye-bye. Soccer City!
Soccer City! Soccer City!
So I've arrived in Johannesburg, I've got my ticket, I use one of the local buses to get here, and if you're one of the lucky fans who's got a ticket to the opening game, this is where the action will take place. The National Stadium of South Africa, the game between Bafana Bafana and the Blue Sharks of Cape Verde. Cape Verde, of course, their first time ever at the Cup of Nations. One thing fans will be praying for as well is the weather. It's meant to be the driest part of the year, but tell that to the clouds.